Coach, congratulations once again. You are the champions of the 2023-24 Gauteng APC Motsepe League. It must be a huge excitement and huge joy for you and your team.
Thank you very much. Firstly, I'd love to thank the players. Very, very, very humbled and tremendous human beings that we're working with. The technical team, the support that they give me, the help that they give. All of them, they are older than me, all my technical members, but they listen to everything that I say. They come up with ideas. Like, it's a very energetic technical team. And another big thanks to the fans. Our supporters have been there since day one when I came back here. That was on the 17th of January when we played Highlands here, and the game did not finish because of the rain. Our supporters have been there since that day until today. And another big thanks to the management of the club. There's just way too much that they're doing for the club, for the players, for the technical team. And a big thanks to Coach Cooley and Coach Alex. I believe that today we are here because of their contribution. If they hadn't started this journey when I was not here, we wouldn't be here today. So it's a very beautiful win, and a win that has so many hands involved. So that's why I cannot take the credit alone, but I have to share with all the people that have actually put in their hands in the mud to get us to this point of being the champions of Gauteng APC Motsepe for the second time, back to back.
Coach, like you said, you mentioned you were not here at the beginning of the season, but you were here last season. You went all the way to the playoffs. Unfortunately, it didn't work out for you guys there. You took a separate journey, you went to Mpumalanga. Coach Kudiso and Coach Bans started the season. You came back after Coach Bans had left, but then Coach Kudiso left and you had to be there alone in the hot seat. What is it in terms of the integration and the handing over that has ensured that as coaches change, the results and the consistency were not interrupted?
Coach Cooley, I feel that he betrayed me. he betrayed me because he had a huge influence in me coming back here. And just when I got here, 4 games together, then he decides to leave. And then the way he told me that he's leaving, I thought he was joking, man. He told me, I think it was on a Thursday, he told me, "Hey, Coach, Vinny, my boy." That's what he would say, "Vinny, my boy, I'm leaving on, this is my last game on Saturday. I'm not coming back. I'm going to join VFA, man." I thought he was joking. And then we trained on Friday, normal. Saturday, we played JPM in Alex. And then he said, "Hey, Vinny, remember that I told you that I'm leaving?" He was saying it jokingly. And I didn't take him serious because I thought he's still joking. But when he made the announcement to the players, that's when I felt that, shit, this is real. And this guy is leaving. But then I got the support of all the remaining technical members. Mahlatsi, he gave me so many clips of the first round games. I watched all of them. I watched all of them on my own. I started going out, watching Highlands, watching Pele Pele, watching Chomo, because I wanted to quickly get back and get used into Josie's system as quick as possible. And the players also gave in their support, they gave in their hearts, they were willing to pull in in the same direction with me. And I feel that the biggest turning point was we changed a bit in how we played. When I was with only Coach J, we changed a bit the dynamics, the personnel, the schemes, how to move, how the pressing patterns. If you check, almost all our goals are similar. When I was here with only Coach J after Coach Cooley left, and if you can check, probably the very same player contributes in all those goals. But then, the most important thing was to keep the spirit very high. Give everybody a chance. Players that works hard, give them, reward them with game time. We have 27 players that are registered with us, and in the 14 games that we've played up to now without Coach Cooley, none of them has never played a game. All of them have tasted the piece of the cake, because we had to do it as collective. So we wanted them to integrate them, increase the level of the competitiveness in within our squad, and start demanding the next of them. And the only way to do that is by playing everybody who raises his hand and say, "Coach, I'm willing to go with you to Wednesday's game or Saturday's game." That's one thing that we actually got right, and the support that we gave to all our young players, the under 23s, we started to bring them more closer, show them their mistakes, where we want them to improve. As much as we fight them during game, we fight so hard with them, but they know training at our training space, there's so much that we are giving them that shows that we are here to help them, we are here to give them support, we are here because we want to see them improve. We had a problem of Alaicha Panda and Koketso Schodiso, we were crying that most of the runs that we make that allows us to play the loop over passes to turn the defense, they always ruin them because they take too many touches on the ball even when it's not necessary. And we did not only tell them, but we showed them moments, we've showed them clips, we came back to training, we worked on it, stop the session, show them the importance of releasing quick when the situations are like this. And today Koketso played. I think he played the entire 90 minutes, and then he played, he never lost the ball. And I was very, very impressed with him, moving the ball very quick, hunting the free spaces. His head today was all over the pitch. He knew what was happening at all times, on and off possession. So that's one thing that I feel that we've won the players' hearts with, to show them that we care, to show them that we want to help them improve in all areas. That tower boy, the left back, I was watching Barcelona on Wednesday when they played PSG. They had a 17-year-old center playing center back, and then I was like, wow, a Champions League, a 17-year-old. And then I quickly reflected back. I said, but then in our team, we have a player by the name Tao. He plays left center back, left back, left center, at the age of 18. And the boy has played the whole 15 games. And in all the 15 games that he has played, we've never lost a game with him in the field of play. And we've kept 9 clean sheets with him in the field. So that's how you win the players. You show them that you care so much, and you want to help them to improve, to get into the next levels.
Coach, last season you went to the playoffs. I know the squad has changed. A lot of players went to for greener pastures. But surprise is here. Marvel is here. Shakes is here. Shasha is here. They remember what happened in KZN. They know what happened in KZN. Perhaps it lingers in their minds. It brings that anxiety and the pleasure of thinking, we've been there, we failed. What is going to happen this time around? The league is that for you on your side is done and dusted. Yes, there are games to play, but you've won it. What is it now that you're going to do to ensure that the minds of those players, old and new, do not perhaps look back to what happened in KZN and think, oh, here we go again, and put themselves under pressure and bring that anxiety to them, which will impede their performance?
I don't want to put pressure on individuals. Based on the fact that they were there. Those who were there, it's a blessing in disguise, because they know exactly what happened. But I want them to go there again with fresh minds, with the positive mind, and with the willingness of going there to work very hard. And I also think that it's a blessing in disguise that this season we did not even qualify for Nedbank, because it had a very huge factor for us not to get promoted last season. But then, that was the negative, that the team couldn't get to be promoted because of Nedbank. Now we were an open book to everybody that we played against. Yet we didn't know most of them. But at the same time, it was a positive thing that we played so well in the Nedbank, because other individuals like your Baloi, your Makungu, your Mapena, Kumete, they got to move into the higher levels because of the impact that we had made in the Nedbank Cup. So it was a win and lose situation. Unfortunately, the team lost, but some individuals won. Kuli also won as well. I also had a share of mine when I went to Mpumalanga. It was all because of the contribution of Nedbank Cup. But now, it's a different ball game, different oppositions, not the ones that we played against last year. Different ones, different place, different field, different personnel. So we stand a very good chance, like everybody that will be coming there. We know that now we've learned, that the game doesn't be won on paper, but you have to get in the field of play and roll up your sleeves and work very hard. The players that were here, they have learned it, and I'm glad that they've learned it the hard way, because I also learned. I'm no longer the same coach that I was last year when I went to the playoffs. I think that pain changed me as well. It grew me. It made me a different person. I also feel that I was not the type of a coach that they needed that time at the playoffs. They needed a bit of a coach that is a bit aggressive on them to push them into the next stage. But then I was a little bit tolerant, because you know personalities. We are in the same. But the process of life, the challenges, the good things will always teach you a thing or two. So we wanna go there and we'll be there. And we'll be counted there. That's all that I can say at the moment.
Thank you very much, my friend. I'm sure we'll talk more before we go to Upington. But yeah, congratulations once again and all the best.
Thank you so much. Thanks.